Something all right in there.
So it's the unit itself.
35 kilometres from Kalgoorlie at the Dust Devils wet plant, a major breakdown has stalled production.
The vibrator on the screen, we can only put one bucket or two buckets in there and it blocks up, so it's designed to shake everything, and by it not working the way it is, it's just going to keep holding us up. If we lose a quarter of an hour every hour, there's an hour gone every 4 hours.
With the vibrating motor not shaking the mesh screen, large rocks are sitting on top of the mesh and blocking the smaller pay dirt from sifting through the screen for processing.
But I don't even have any power here, Jake.
It'll be those loose wires up there.
So the light went off on the box.
Yeah, so it's just got a short inside, two buckets in, and straight into a problem with the vibrating motor on the screen. So always something going wrong. The vibrating motor for the screen doesn't want to play the game today. So I think it might be a loose wire in here. A little constant vibrations, you know, things come loose every now and again. It's one of those unforeseen issues that always tend to arise when you're ready to rock and roll. All breakdowns are frustrating. That's the thing about the gold game. There's always something going wrong.
So we really need to get the gold out from this wet plant, just so that we do have the capital to spend up at Mika to get that hard rock happening. Without it, then we'd only be just processing very small amounts of rock, and it'll just take you a lifetime. And really, we want to get a lot bigger and get it done a lot quicker.
But with little breakdowns like this, it just keeps pushing that finishing line a bit further away. Loss of production costs you around, could be $10,000, $20,000 a day sometimes. It's frustrating, we've shut down. Yeah, just got to get back into the game and finish this dirt off. We can take the shaker unit off. We can have a play with it out there where it's not as confined and ergonomically impossible to deal with. Or we just remove it, the screen, and get back into it.
Remove the screen?
I don't know about you, but I want to finish this dirt that we got here, meet our target, because it's just going to hold us up. So if we're shut down all day with this thing, we're losing money, we're not finding the gold we need, and we're just being delayed.
Safe as houses.
Well, she's off.
That should do it, eh?
Let's get this show on the road, eh?
All right.
No, any time that we're shut down, you know, we're just not earning. We're not losing money, we're just not making it.
So now that we've taken the screen mesh off the Grizzly, we've got to be really wary that we don't put any big oversized material on the conveyor and into the scrubber unit of the trommel. Basically, it'll just clog everything up, and we've got to get in there and clean it all out, and it's not a pretty job, so.
Told him to slow right down.
A bit annoying because what the screen would normally do, I've got to do. Well, fingers crossed, it stays operating really good. It takes ages to get a bucket through when you're trickle feeding it like this.
He hasn't bobbed it yet.
No. When it's not turning, we're not earning. Got to keep the machine running. All right, see if we can finally finish this dirt.
Fun and games today.
Yeah.
That's how gold mining is, yeah. Anything to do with machinery, you're always going to have breakdowns.
Doing a little test.
Yeah, see what's coming through.
Yeah.
A little bit in there.
Nice chunk, that one.
Yeah. Not as much as I was hoping for, though. So, yeah, there's quite a few big coarse pieces in here, which is good to see. Oh,
keep going. We're getting there. Gram by gram. Just had a low oil pressure alarm shut down the generator. So we need the big generator to run the wet plant. We can run the pumps with little generators, but to turn that trommel inside that wet plant, we need a very large generator, which is this one here.
Oh, look, my patience gets tested every day. you always got issues going wrong and things breaking down. You just gotta have the foresight and plan ahead and try and hope with your fingers crossed that everything's gonna come out on top the way you want it to. Might change this all tomorrow, Jake. Pretty dirty, it's burning, so it's leaving a stain on the fingers. I just don't think the gold gods want us to leave at the moment. Keep throwing problem after problem at us. It's pretty hot too. Nice to let it open up all the doors, let it cool down.
The intense heat may be impacting the oil pressure, but with no power source, the Dust Devils could face finishing their season over 10 ounces short of target.
But without the generator, we're dead in the water. So we're just gonna do a quick oil change on the generator. We're going to change the filters out as well.
With extreme temperatures set to shut down their season in a couple of days, the Dust Devils are battling a barrage of machine breakdowns. They're struggling to process their final truckload of pay dirt to recover the more than 10 ounces of gold they need to reach their record 400-ounce season target.
By the end of the day, if we can't get the generator going, we're dead in the water. When you're this close to the end of the season, and things start breaking down all over the shop, you know, it's very frustrating. But you just got to persevere with it, keep going. All right, isolator off. Ready to crank her up, mate. Press the go button.
Very good.
So everything's running all right. We'll be able to get all the dirt through today, hopefully, and
just had a look at the oil pressure. That's sitting quite nice, and the temperature's fine as well, so.
Fingers crossed that's the problem sorted, and we're not gonna have any more dramas with it.
As long as nothing breaks down, that'll be good.
All we need to do today is just get the gold out. We'll be doing a clean-up pretty shortly.
A sample pan from the riffle trays will give the Dust Devils the first sign of whether they'll come close to the 10.5 ounces they need from the final truckload of pay dirt.
Oh, it looks pretty good so far.
Well, that's incredible.
Awesome.
Yeah, hey,
absolutely. Put it there, awesome. Huh?
800 ounces next season.
Oh, there's just so much gold, it's ridiculous. There's probably 2 ounces in his pan, easy. I don't think we've seen a pan this season with that much gold in it, so you just forget about all the breakdowns and all the drama you've had all season. Makes it all worthwhile.
Not much left to find to reach that 400 mark. It's been a real testing week. The amount of things that have gone wrong so far is crazy, but to be able to see that sort of gold in the pan makes it all worthwhile.
Let's find out, I want to know.
At their Kalgoorlie workshop, it's the final weigh-up for the Dust Devils.
So it all basically comes down to this last gold pour. Hopefully we meet our target, and hopefully a little bit more.
That's it.
Have we made it or not?
Put him down there.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, not too bad. What's wrong with
that? A bit of water, the hose pull, and
I reckon we've cracked the 400.
It looks all right, doesn't it?
They need to weigh up just over 10 ounces from this final season gold pour to hit their record-breaking 400-ounce season target.
Oh, well, let's see what we got.
Certainly has.
I can't believe it.
21.5.
That's unreal.
411.
Oh, yeah. Nailed our target. Over 400 ounces, 411.
Fantastic.
That's brilliant.
Their massive haul at a staggering gold price of $2,640 an ounce smashes their $1 million target and sets a record for the highest season haul on Aussie Gold Hunters history.
Jubilation. We've nailed it, so.
It's been a long, hard season. We've put in a lot of effort, so to be able to make that 400-ounce target, yeah, we couldn't be happier.
To be honest, it's a ridiculous figure that we've hit in our first year of jumping all together in one big group. So, yeah, we're fully stoked. Feels like victory.
We're just them sort of people that never give up. We have breakdowns, we fix it, and we get going again. We just never say die.
To finish the season is something we've never done before. It's all new to us as gold prospectors doing this sort of thing. Achieving it, it's fantastic.
Next on the radar for us is take it up a notch, go to the next level, and we'll hit some hard rock mining.